Good evening, everyone. We are back again with some motivational stuff. Let's start.
What's stopping you? Are you too tired? Didn't get enough sleep? Don't have enough energy? Don't have enough time? Is that what's stopping you right now? Don't have enough money? Is that the thing? Or is the thing that's stopping you, you?
Excuses sound best to the person that's making them up. Stop feeling sorry for yourself. Get off the pity potty. Telling everybody your sad and sob stories, trying to get people to show up to your pity potties and your pity parades. If you ever see me in a Rolls Royce, a 6 or 7 star hotel, living my life to the fullest, don't get jealous of me, because I worked my ass off to get it. Nobody handed me nothing. Wake your ass up. Awaken the beast inside. It's game on. It's go season. It's time for you to take advantage of the access and the resources that you have in your country and your community. You got a problem with your life. You got a problem with your environment. Do something about it. If you want it, go get it.
Recognize the excuses are not valid. They're conjured up. They're fabricated. They're lies. And how do you stop the lies? You stop the lies with the truth. That the truth is, you have time. You have the skill, you have the knowledge and the support and the willpower and the discipline to get it done.
The fruit of everything good in life begins with a challenge. Everything is a pill that's required. And it's not going to come to you, and it's not going to fall in your lap, and it's not going to be something that, oh my God, it just was so simple. It's always going to be difficult. If you want it, you gotta go get it. This is your chance. This is your shot. This is your moment. This is your time. This is your place. This is your opportunity.
This is my time. This is my moment. Tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. Ain't no such thing as tomorrow. We only got today. It's your dream. If you want to have it, lift your butt up and make it happen. If you want to have it, rise and grind.
You still got work to do. Stay on that basketball court. Stay on that football field. It's grind season, homie.
Hello and good evening, everyone. This is a short talk on healthy and fit. I'm your host and coach. Today, I'm talking from my experiences, being logical, and I'm not a doctor. And my experiences tells me what? Take care of your body. It is the only place you have to live. So the title of the today's talk is Healthy and Fit. It has never happened before that we humans became so more insecure about our bodies than we are today. And this mindset is not helping us. The only thing it is helping is the market. We are being fooled in the name of health and wellness. Instagram, today's trend of presence. If you just type health on Instagram, you will find 4.2 million posts for health, 122 million posts for healthy, and 161 million posts for healthy living. Let's go a little deep inside with an example. You all must agree to it that green tea is best option to become healthy. Am I right? Okay. Let me tell you that green tea is considered the elixir to health. 3 cups of green tea a day and you are superhuman. You can burn fat, prevent diabetes, improve your brain functions, and prevent cancer. That's what we have been told. Hey all, pause for a second. Think again. Really? Green tea? Is it? If green tea could prevent cancer, our cancer researchers would be vacationing in Tuscany with a glass of fine red wine. Trust me, green tea cannot make you lose weight. It is just marketing. However, what I agree to the fact that it can improve our metabolism, which by the way, almost any tea can. Well, drink green tea for sure, but don't count on it for losing weight. Just for information, green tea is the highest selling wellness product of 2019. The global green tea market was worth $18.4 billion. There are many such examples. Let's move on and see what exactly the things are waiting for. Kiona, oats, smoothies, kale and seeds, so many of them. Chia, sunflower, pumpkin, flax, sesam, hemp, whatnot. Sometimes I see my lunch or dinner plate at home in such a way that it is garbage and unhealthy. When we were young, we were told that home food is healthy food. However, sometimes around the 19 came a breakfast revolution, cornflakes, and trend continues to grow. Unbelievable. Educated being fooled with fancy words. Sharing stats, the global health and wellness industry is currently booming. And why selling our shortcomings to becoming thin? Sorry, healthy. To cut the story short, watch this video.
आंटी के पेट में ना छोटा सा बेबी।
अंकल के पेट में भी बेबी है।
It's okay.
Let's talk about fitness. The level of obsession with the idea of health has gone too far. It is good for Indian mentality where fitness is least priority until one is hit by some medical disease. However, I am against with the flawed idea of health, the one world teaches us. The slim is healthy and healthy is slim. The answer is simple. Losing weight is a game of calories. You need to burn more than you consume. You need to reach a calorie deficit, which you can do by eating junk food, fried food, McDonald's, pizzas, cookies, Peking duck. Let's talk about another fancy name. Gluten-free meals. For health, gluten-free is not helping us. It is taking away the much-needed carbs. Who is it helping? An average gluten-free product is 242% more expensive than their variant that contains gluten. In 3 years, the global gluten-free market is expected to touch $6.47 billion, and by 2077, it will cross more than $43 billion. Let's have a look.
30% of people want to eat less gluten. 18% of adults buy gluten-free foods, and it's expected to be a $15 billion industry by 2016. But experts say only 1% of Americans have disorders like celiac disease, specifically caused by gluten. So what gives? Many people think they have a syndrome called non-celiac gluten sensitivity, and now research is telling us that it probably doesn't exist. Gluten is a protein composite. You find it a lot in wheat, barley, and other grains. It's the stuff that makes bread chewy and is used a lot as a meat substitute. So why has it riled up people everywhere? Our story begins in Australia. Back in 2011, a guy named Peter Gibson published a crucial study finding that gluten can cause gastrointestinal distress in people who don't have celiac disease. The study sent the gluten-free craze into orbit. But Gibson wasn't satisfied, so he went back to the lab and followed up. And these follow studies have changed his original conclusions. Here's what he did. 37 self-identified gluten-sensitive patients with irritable bowel syndrome were tested. They were cycled through various diets of both gluten and non-gluten, which didn't contain other stuff that could aggravate the gut. When the study was over, researchers discovered that no matter what diet the patients were on, many of them had intestinal problems anyways. The patients expected to feel bad on the study diets, so they did. As for gluten, Gibson concluded that it wasn't a factor, it made no difference. So gluten might not be the big bad wolf people think it is.
Here is what else is fooling us. Milk. Most of us have had cow milk all our lives, but now we are being told that cow milk makes us fat. The global almond milk market is expected to reach beyond $13 billion by 2025. Soya milk, more than $23 billion. Apparently, they are healthier than cow milk. Composition-wise, there is no proof that soy or almond milk is healthier than cow milk. When it comes to nutrition density and protein content, cow milk wins the race clearly. Here's another product, protein powder. These tubs are as heavy as dumbbell and they cost as much as gold. We need to understand, is protein powder supplement? It comes into play if you fail to reach your daily protein goal. For a woman, it is 46 grams. And for a man, it is 56 grams. You can meet this target by eating eggs, nuts, milk, chicken, soy chunks, and even if you do not hit that 46 or 56 grams mark every day of the week, you will not be prosecuted. There is no need to spend a fortune on these protein powders. That is, unless you want to contribute to its $6 billion market. Those selling health products will not tell you about the risk associated with it. What are its long-term effects? No one knows. These products are too new. Here's what else is not necessarily healthy. Brown alternatives. Brown rice, brown bread, brown sugar. Of late, we tend to prefer them to the white variants. That did sound racist. It was totally unintended nutrition-wise. The difference between brown rice and white rice is negligible. MRP wise, the difference is hefty. Furthermore, health snacks, low calorie, fat free, baked, non-fried, air fried, cholesterol free, oof, what not. None of these claims matter. Ingredients, rather low fat snack, have added sugar and they hide controversial ingredients under technical names like E47, E621, etc., etc. You see, social media and its target marketing is a danger to public health. A lot of us have fallen for it. Many of us have recovered years of healthy food obsession and spending a fortune later years. What I have concluded, home food is healthy. Home food is the only tried and tested superfood. If you want to lose weight, aim for a calorie deficit. If you want to be healthy, eat a balanced diet. Remember, food is not your enemy. Self-doubt and false advertisement are. Chill pill, eat well at home. Enjoy your plates and remember, home food is the God's gift. And dal roti zindabad. We have 24 hours in a day and our body just demands 40 minutes of any type of workout. You may get to watch sunrise every day. Feel it. I'm sure you will find yourself lucky. Concluding with Akshay Kumar's fitness mantra. Thank you for watching. Take care. Stay fit. Stay healthy. Stay active. And stay tuned.
I don't party. Not that I'm saying party is bad for health. I don't say that. But I believe there's no need to, because I don't enjoy it. I sleep every day at around 9, 9:30. I get up at 4 o'clock. Duniya mein, matlab, main aapko batau, ek baat batana chahata hun ki maine ऐसा दिन कोई नहीं हुआ है मेरी जब से मैं पैदा हुआ हूं तब से आज तक कि ऐसा दिन कभी नहीं गया कि मैंने उगता सूरज नहीं देखा. I have always seen the sun. Nothing. This is all in your hands. Your health is in your hands. Your life is in your hands. It is the most simplest thing. We make it. You know, एकदम confusion कर देते हैं. We make it very complicated. जैसे हमारे यहाँ मैं देखता हूँ कि कितने लोगों को पेट की problem है, मोटापा है. Simple सा हिसाब, उसका हिसाब है. अगर आपको आप एक घंटा नहीं दे सकते अपने शरीर को कसरत करने के लिए, और दूसरा 6:30 के बाद खाना की खाने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, आपका शरीर नहीं मांगता इतना खाना, पागलों की तरह मैं ठूसते जा रहा है इंसान। 6:30 मतलब सूरज ढलने के बाद, उसके बाद कोई जरूरत नहीं है, 1 घंटा दो अपने शरीर को, 6:30 के बाद खाना बंद कर दो, देखो आपकी सेहत कहां से कहां पहुंच जाएगी। सिंपल थिंग है, सिंपल।